Mining is the process of using computer hardware to do mathematical calculations for the blockchain network in order to confirm transactions and create new blocks. Mining is the term used with blockchain as a metaphor for the process of coal miners who extract material from the earth. Blockchain miners extract blocks. They do this by collecting transactions into a block and then submit a proposal after solving a cryptographic puzzle. The current block includes the hash of the previous block, which creates a connection. And this is really how all blocks are chained. The hash of the most current block has some information about the very first block in the chain. In this video, I'll discuss more about how the mining process works in relation to Bitcoin and Ethereum. Let's get started exploring mining on the Bitcoin network. Each Bitcoin block contains a number of transactions. Each block holds up to 1 megabyte of transaction data, which means there can be a few thousand transactions in a single block. Miners get to select which transactions make up the block that they create. The block of the transactions are then verified and then become added to the chain. And miners receive a transaction fee and a block reward for the work they've done as a result. The block reward started at 50 Bitcoin initially and has halved periodically since 2009. After 210,000 blocks are mined, or approximately every 4 years, the block reward halves. So around the year 2140, all Bitcoin will be minted and the reward will be zero. The reward is now currently at 6.25 and will halve again in about 2024 to 3.125. When the reward goes away, all that will be left is the transaction fees. Two factors typically determine transaction fees. Those factors are network congestion and transaction size. When the network is congested or really busy, users will increase their transaction fee so that miners will choose their transactions and they can get confirmed in a block sooner. This makes the average transaction fee fluctuate quite a bit depending on how busy the network is. In 2018, there was a huge spike where fees reached nearly $60, but typically the fees have averaged about $1 in 2020. Miners are all racing to be the first to solve the complex hashing puzzle to the current block problem. The block problem is designed to take about 10 minutes to solve, so whoever gets there first announces to the world they have found the solution in a Coinbase transaction. And then everyone can rehash the input to generate the output and come to the same conclusion that this is a valid block. So Coinbase is the transaction that adds the Bitcoin to the system. And once the Coinbase transaction is put up and verified, the miner is rewarded a certain crypto amount. In order for a transaction to be chosen, it needs to be agreed upon and then added to the block. So transaction validation is not the real purpose of mining. The real purpose is really to keep people engaged and to have a secure network. By only allowing a megabyte of data in each transaction, the system prevents people from getting too greedy. This also means that, you know, Bitcoin isn't really for everyday purchases like buying a coffee or a movie ticket, for example, since it will take time for a miner to verify a transaction and, you know, work goes into that. So miners typically go for bigger transaction fees, which, you know, also means bigger transactions, since those are the ones that are going to be verified first, likely. Now let's talk about the process for mining on the Ethereum network. Generally speaking, the process is about the same, but some details differ. So for a transaction to be verified, it must go through the mining process where miners solve the block puzzle and create a new block of valid transactions. Ethereum has transaction rounds that are 10 to 15 seconds. And this transaction time is so short because Ethereum is designed to have smart contracts, which are executed in more real time. So when a miner validates a new block, they are rewarded with a certain amount of Ether. And each block can also have a number of transactions, usually, of course, at least one. But the number of transactions in the block is going to be limited by the amount of gas they have to use. Gas is what prevents miners from getting greedy and running infinite tasks. Currently, a miner receives 2 Ether as a reward plus any transaction fees. The average transaction fee as of 2020 was about less than a dollar, let's say about 75 cents to the dollar. And the max the transaction fee has ever been has been about $5. So just like with Bitcoin, the transaction fees will spike in periods of high congestion on the network. And by the end of 2018, there were over 100 million Ether in circulation. So Ethereum does not have the same scarcity as Bitcoin does. So after hearing about the mining process, you might be asking to yourself, is it even worth it to mine at all? And as an individual miner, no, it's really not worth it. And it's not even possible on your individual computer, the computers that you're using at home on a day-to-day. The only way to be able to really mine effectively is to have a custom CPU and custom hardware. And this is really where the emergence of mining pools come from. So mining pools are going to be pools of individuals that come together and that have really complex hardware that can run these intense searches. So one last thing to note about mining for now. With cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Ethereum, it is likely that most miners are part of these mining pools and not working as individuals. The pools are going to allow them to combine resources and use server farms with, again, really sophisticated hardware and lots of computational problems to solve these hashing problems. So those are the principles of mining. I've stuck to talking about mining as it relates to Bitcoin and Ethereum, but the same principles generally apply for any blockchain network.